An electron within any given atom can have two different types of angular momentum. One of these angular momentum we call the orbital angular momentum, and a second angular momentum we call the spin angular momentum. Now, the orbital angular momentum given by uppercase L with the arrow symbol on top, we already actually spoke about in our discussion on the magnetic dipole moment of our electron and the Bohr magneton. So, in that discussion, we basically were able to apply the quantum theory to the orbit of the electron around the nucleus of our atom. So, we basically said that if we treat the electron as a particle orbiting the nucleus of the atom, it creates mu, the magnetic dipole moment. And the magnetic dipole moment mu of that electron's orbit around the nucleus of that atom depends on the orbital angular momentum given by L. So equation 1 gives us a relationship between the magnetic dipole moment that is created by the orbital angular momentum L. So mu is equal to negative E divided by 2m multiplied by L, where L is the orbital angular momentum, E is the charge on that electron, m is the mass of that electron, and the negative means that the directions of these two vectors is opposite. So if L points up, mu points downward, and vice versa. Now, equation 3 basically tells us that the orbital angular momentum uppercase L can be calculated using the orbital quantum number given by lowercase l. So we see that the orbital quantum number determines the orbital angular momentum by equation 3. Now, equation 2 is basically a specific case for when the external magnetic field in which our atom is placed into points along the z-axis. So that means in such a case, the mu, the magnetic dipole moment, will point along that same axis, and it can be calculated using this equation, where mu b is simply the Bohr magneton, it's a constant, and ml is the magnetic quantum, the number of our electron, which actually depends on the orbital quantum number L. So once again, we see that one of the types of the angular momentum of the electron comes from the orbital quantum number, and this is known as the orbital angular momentum. Now, the second type of angular momentum, which basically comes from the electron spin of that electron, is known as the spin quantum number, and this is given by uppercase S, where this simply means, the arrow means that just like the orbital angular momentum, this is a vector. It has magnitude as well as direction. Now, electrons also have an intrinsic angular momentum that is independent of the orbital angular momentum L, and we call this the spin angular momentum. Now, this type of angular momentum does not depend on the orbital quantum number L, but instead it depends on the spin quantum number given by MS. So this equation basically gives us our magnitude of our magnetic dipole moment mu that points along the z-axis in terms of our spin quantum number ms. So this is the magnetic dipole moment that is created not because of the orbital quantum number L, but is created as a result of the spin quantum number ms, where g is a constant known as the G factor. So basically, there are two different types of angular momentum that an electron can have. One of these angular momentum is the orbital angular momentum that comes from the orbital quantum number L, and the second one is the spin angular momentum S that comes from the spin quantum number. Now, we can define the total angular momentum of our electron given by uppercase J with the the vector symbol on top as simply the vector sum of the orbital angular momentum L and the spin angular momentum S. So if we take the sum of these two vectors, that will give us the total angular momentum. Now, in the same way that the orbital angular momentum depends on the orbital quantum number and the spin angular momentum depends on the spin quantum number, we can define a new quantum number known as the total angular momentum quantum number. So basically, the total angular momentum given by uppercase J can be calculated using something known as the lowercase j, which we call the total angular momentum quantum number. So uppercase J is the total angular momentum and lowercase j is the total angular momentum quantum number. And the total angular momentum quantum number is a value that is a positive quantity. That means J cannot take values that are negative. An equation 2 allows us to determine what the value of the total angular momentum quantum number is. So basically, lowercase j is equal to the sum of the orbital quantum number L and the spin quantum number S. So basically, we replace ms with simply s. So if we take the sum of the spin quantum number and the orbital quantum number, that will give us lowercase j, the total angular momentum quantum number. Now, what exactly is the relationship between the total angular momentum given by uppercase J and lowercase J, the total angular momentum quantum number? Well, it is given by this equation. So the magnitude of the total angular momentum uppercase J is equal to the product of h bar, a constant, so h divided by 2 pi, where h is Planck's constant, multiplied by the square of J multiplied by J plus 1. So notice this equation is very similar to equation 3, except our L has been replaced with J, which is the total angular momentum quantum number that is given by this equation. So this equation gives us the total angular momentum, and we see that we can use the total angular momentum quantum number to determine what the magnitude of the total angular momentum is. So let's finally look at the following really quick example in which we're going to determine the possible values of our J, the total angular momentum quantum number. So in this example, we want to determine the values that J, the total angular momentum quantum number, can take for an electron found inside the 3p orbital of our hydrogen atom. So the 3 simply means that the principal quantum number n is equal to 3, and the p gives us the information about what type of orbital quantum number we are dealing with. So because we are dealing with the p orbital, that means L is equal to 1. So in this equation, L is equal to 1. And remember, the electron spin of any electron can take one of two values, either positive 1/2 or negative 1/2. So we take equation 2 and we say that J is equal to L plus S, where L is 1 because our orbital is P and S can either be positive or negative 1/2. So J is equal to 1 plus minus 1/2. Now if we use the plus, that will give us J is equal to 3 divided by 2. If we use the negative, that means J is equal to 1 divided by 2.